Next, we have a huge range of options for maintaining a level of challenge. For example, a fixed number of sets, rounds, hands that we play. In tennis, double faults keep the game from dragging on. We mentioned research showing around a 44% optimal level of unpredictability. We've shown how a change of scale, such as a lower or higher basketball hoop, changes the whole game. Card games like bridge involve getting and sharing information from others. Within the stack of cards is an unseen but finite pool of items. In other words, I have an ace, so I know there can only be three other aces in the pack. Sometimes the game changes abruptly, as when we declare a trump suit. A game goes into overtime. Someone is fouled and gets a penalty shot. We can put extra weightings on things, like a three-point throw, or ending on an exact dice throw. To even things up, we can restrict alternatives and set boundaries. In music, we might play blues, pentatonic, or three-chord songs. That's the basis of my Ozrock music system. We can limit actions by providing inertia. In the hanging ball example, the ball has inertia and keeps moving even if we miss the shot. A neurological patient doesn't have to throw the ball. They can make things happen merely by deflecting the ball. Computer games can do this automatically. The first games like Pong and Space Invaders kept the sprites in motion, so all you had to do was block them. The arcade tradition has become a bit fancier, but basically it's the same reaction to something on a digital screen. So these are a few of the techniques used to level a playing field. For homework, have another look at the games and sports you reviewed in earlier modules and see if you can spot any of these techniques.